أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم My dear student السلام عليكم Today this is our 12th lecture on advanced geochemistry Today our topic is numeric effect and then we will discuss conformations due to heteroatoms like nitrogen phosphorus sulfur and oxygen containing compounds and we have discussed a lot about the conformations of the organic compounds but today we will discuss a little bit about the conformations that's why there is no need to be worried that how much material is going to be collected but according to the syllabus we are trying our best to give you a very comprehensive knowledge so that you can come up with basic and advanced stereochemistry concept key concepts of the today lectures are numeric effect and then we will discuss the conformational of compounds having nitrogen phosphorus and sulfur in the ring these are our key concepts of today lectures anomerific effect except for hydroxyl groups a polar glycone group tends to attain the axial orientation as for example methoxy acetoxy chloro This is due to interaction between the lone pair of electrons of the ring oxygen atom and those of the substituent at C1. This interaction is less for axial than for equatorial. This phenomenon is called anomeric effect. In the below figures, you can see the clear conformation of a compounds in which it has been shown clearly that if the group is axially oriented if any group like methoxy acetoxy or chloro group then this is due to interaction between the lone pair of electrons of ring oxygen atom and those of substituent at C1 this interaction less for axial than for equatorial means if the group is at equatorial then this effect will be more this is the electronic interaction simply if you see in the diagram anomeric effect means if the there is interaction of electronic interaction of oxygen which is present in the ring with the substituent at C1 because this is the anomeric carbon C1 is the anomeric carbon why we are giving it the C1 because the group attached the substituent attached over here that is why the electrons of oxygen are going to interact with the substituents and this interaction is less axial because if you see the structure that this axial has gone away from the electronic environment of oxygen that is why this interaction is not built in case of axial but in case of equatorial if the group is oriented equatorial then the interaction is electronic interaction is built which electronic interaction electrons of oxygen are going to interact with the substituent C1 this interaction this phenomena is called anomeric effect the anomeric effect is more pronounced in solvents of low dielectric constant you must understand the meaning of dielectric constant mean the most polar solvent the solvent which have polarity have high value of dielectric constant and the compounds which have low polarity means which have less polar character have low value of dielectric constant and less important in solvents of high dielectric constant and less important in solvents of high dielectric constant, example water. This is apparent from percentage of victorial form of 2-methoxy tetrahydropyrene in various solvents. This is the apparent diagram of anomeric effect in which is the 2-methoxy tetrahydropyrene in various solvents. For anomeric effect, solvents play an important role. Means if you are using low dielectric constant solvents, then the anomeric effect will be high, and the anomeric effect will be slightly low in case of if you are using high dielectric constant solvents like water, methanol, ethanol, DMSO, acetonitrile, DMF. These all have high value of dielectric constant. If you will use the solvents of low dielectric constant, then the anomeric effect will be maximum. Once again, I would like to explain anomeric effect. Except for hydroxyl group, apolar aglycone group tends to attain the axial orientation, as for example methoxy, acetoxy, chloro, etc. This is due to interaction between the lone pair electrons of ring oxygen atom and those of the substituent at C1. This interaction is less for axial than for equatorial. This phenomena is called anomeric effect. Means if the substituent is oriented in equatorial position, then the electronic interaction will be maximum, and furthermore this interaction can be increased when we will use solvents of low dielectric constant. Furthermore, if the substituent at C1 is oriented axially, then the electronic environment will not affect, and the because it will go away from the oxygen, that is why electronic interaction is not built. This interaction of electron of oxygen which are present in the ring with the substituent C1 is called anomeric effect. This is called the anomeric effect. Students, please understand it, that the oxygen has two lone pair of electrons, and this substituent also has electron, and these electronic interaction can be only built as at optimum distance. As the group go away from the position of equatorial to axial, then these electron interactions cannot be built. That is why anomeric effect cannot be pronounced in case of axial position. Only at equatorial position the electronic interaction is built. This is called the anomeric effect. This effect can be possible in, this is the example of 2-methoxy tetrahydropyrene in various solvents. You can see the solvent, this is CCl4, dielectric constant 2.2, percentage of equatorial form 17%. This is deuterated benzene, its dielectric constant 2.3 and its equatorial position is 18%, CS2 2.6 20 and DMSO D6 26%, CDCl3 is dielectric constant is 4.8 and 29%, and in deuterated methanol its dielectric constant 32 and its percentage equatorial form is 31. Similarly D2O, its dielectric constant 78 and its percentage equatorial form is 48%. Now, nitrogen compound. Tertiamines of the type NABC are not resolvable because the nitrogen oscillates very rapidly. Why oscillation means? Moving through and through motion is called oscillates. Means umbrella-like movement due to lone pair of electrons, because the nitrogen accelerates very rapidly, 2.3 into 10 power 10 per second at right angle to the plane containing a B and C. Thus, the product is mirror image of the starting material racemization results. You can see in the structure that it is shown that the nitrogen containing A, B, C groups, and these are lone pair of electrons, and the geometry has become tetrahedron. Troger base in which this umbrella type oscillation is not possible can be resolvable into optically isomers. Troger as the basis in which their oscillation is not umbrella type oscillation. Umbrella type means just like umbrella. Umbrella type oscillation is not possible can be resolvable into optical isomers. Generally speaking, the compound is resolvable if the energy barrier is 50 to 63 kilojoule per mole. In the above case, it is only 25 kilojoule per mole. This is the nitrogen containing compound. Then conformation of nitrogen containing rings. In an ethyl azidine, two hydrogen atoms cis to an ethyl and two hydrogen trans to it can be differentiated by NMR spectroscopy at room temperature. At 110 degree, only one broad band is observed. It is predicted that it should be possible to resolve it at minus 50 degrees Celsius. Means, if in conformations of nitrogen containing rings, this is the nitrogen containing ring, this is the N-ethyl azidine, this is the N-ethyl azidine, two hydrogen atoms cis to N-ethyl and two hydrogen trans to it can be differentiated by NMR spectroscopy because two protons have different environment at room temperature. At 110 degree, only one broad band is observed. It is predicted that it should be possible to resolve it at minus 50 degree. Means at minus 50, the movements of the electron proton is restricted. Rotation is not possible. That way it can be differentiated, it can be resolvable. Otherwise, at room temperature, there is flipping. One proton is going to be exchanged with other proton. That is why both have got different orientation and two broadband peaks are observed in the NMR spectroscopy. Then this pyrrolidine has a puckered ring and undergoes a pseudo rotation. Pyrrolidine has a puckered ring and undergoes a pseudo rotation. This means puckering is not fixed but rotates around the ring. Each carbon and nitrogen atom oscillates in a direction perpendicular to the average plane of the ring. This is the envelope shape of pyrrolidine, and this is the half chair conformation of pyrrolidine. It has puckered structure, but puckered structure means it has pseudo rotation. This means puckering is not fixed but rotates around the ring. Means rotation is possible around the ring. Each carbon and nitrogen atom oscillates in direction perpendicular to the average plane of the ring. Means there is a possibility of oscillation of atoms of nitrogen and carbon to rotate around the ring. Then there is piperidine, exists mainly in the chair form. The conformation 2 predominates, but in N-methyl piperidine form 3 predominates as CH3 group tries to occupy equatorial position. This is the piperidine. Piperidine mainly exists in chair form, chair conformation. Its different conformation is possible if R is H. R can be H. Then two isomers. Then R can be CH3 and CH3, two more isomers. It means, but in an methyl piperidine form, 3 predominates as CH3 group tries to occupy equatorial position. The effect of lone pair orbital is to be ignored unless there is a polar group on the adjacent carbon atom. If there is an OH group at C4 pyridine may assume a boat form due to hydrogen bonding. From this, it has shown that if the group attached to the pyridine, if it is oriented, if there is OH group at C4 position, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, then its shape can become a boat shape because a hydrogen bonding, intramolecular hydrogen bonding can be built up between the nitrogen and the hydrogen of OH group, and it can assume the boat shape conformation. And the it is shown clearly that the pyridine usually exists in chain conformation. As the group is attached at C4 position, then its conformation can be changed, means it can assume the shape of boat form due to hydrogen bonding. This can be asked a question from you, that why pyridine exists in boat form when there is a OH group at the C4 position. Then you can give the answer that due to hydrogen bonding, it assumes the shape of boat form rather than chair form. Conformation of N members rings. N is equal to 3 cyclopropane. Cyclopropane has banana shaped CC bond. This is banana shaped CC bond, cyclopropane, 60 degree and 105 degree. Similarly, N is equal to 4 cyclobutane. Cyclobutane exists in the puckered form because the planar form involves eclipsing of bond. This is the planar structure. This is the cis. This is the more stable form. This is the trans. This is the less stable form, because here there is a interaction of bulky groups which make destabilize. Furthermore, there is ring strain and a lot of other factors. That way, cis is more stable and then trans isomer. Then N is equal to 5 cyclopentane could be planar or puckered, but the puckered form is more stable because the planar form involves eclipsing of the CH bonds. There are two main puckered forms. In one of them, the envelope conformation, 4C carbon atoms are in one plane and the fifth is the outside. The other half chair conformation has 3 carbon atoms in one plane and the other two outside. Cyclopentane undergoes pseudo rotation as discussed in case of pyridine, means cyclopentane also undergoes pseudo rotation. Due to this pseudo rotation, means by picking one bond, then we can rotate all the 5 carbon can rotate around the ring. That is why pseudo rotation is possible. This is the half chair conformation of cyclopentane. Then N is equal to 7 cycloheptane. There are two stable conformation. Twist chair is slightly more favorable than the twist boat. Both of them are flexible. This is twist chair cyclopentane. This is twist boat form, means twist boat is less favorable while twist chair is more favorable. Interconversion of ectorial and axial bonds occur through pseudo rotations. Again, here there is a pseudo rotation, and sometimes axial will go to ectorial and ectorial will go to the axial. Then there is N is equal to 8. The cyclooctane, the most stable conformation is boat chair form. This is the boat chair form. One side is boat form, other is the chair form. This is cyclooctane. It may exist in the most stable conformation is the boat chair conformation in case of cyclooctane. Cyclononane has a flexible symmetrical form. This has symmetry. That is has a flexible symmetrical form. N10 cyclodecane has the double chair conformation joined with axial bond. This is double chair conformation. This is one chair, this is other chair. In the medium sized ring, there is a opposition strain, angle strain and steric strain. The interaction between atoms on opposite sides of the ring produces transannual stain. From cyclodecane onwards, the rings are stainless and the heat of combustion per se to group is close to acyclic compounds. Then this angle stain. The normal carbon-carbon bond in cyclopropane is 60 degree, in cyclobutane is 90 degree, in cyclopentane it is 108 degree and in cyclohexane it is 120 degree. Therefore, the angle has to be deformed considerably in these rings. Bayer proposed that this deformation from the normal angle causes a strain and consequently the ring is less stable. The higher is the strain, this is known as Bayer strain theory, and the strain is known as angle or Bayer strain. According to this theory, the stability will increase from cyclopropane to cyclobutane to cyclopentane and then decreases again. The Bayer strain theory assumes all rings to be planar. We have, however, seen that this is not so. Cyclohexane is particularly stainless. According to Bayer strain theory, I would like to explain to you simply that as the ring of size increases, the stability increases because angle increases. If you keep in mind the structure of cyclopropane, cyclopropane has 60 degree angle while cyclobutane has 90 degree. When we compare the stability of cyclopropane with cyclobutane, then it is clearly understandable that cyclobutane is more stable as compared to cyclopropane. The reason for more stability of cyclobutane is that the angle has been increased. There is angle strain in cyclopropane. Similarly, in cyclopentane, the angle has been increased and cyclopentanes are more stable as compared to cyclobutane. Similarly, cyclohexane have attained the angle of 120, which is planar, triangular plane shape. That is why it is more stable as compared to other analog. Therefore, the angle has to be deformed considerably in these rings. Bayer proposed that this deformation from normal angle causes a strain and consequently the ring is less stable. The higher is the strain, this is known as Bayer strain theory, and the strain is known as angle strain or Bayer strain. According to this theory, the stability will increase from cyclopropane through cyclobutane to cyclopentane and then decrease again. The Bayer strain theory assumes all rings to be planar. We have, however, seen that this is not so. Cyclohexane is particularly stainless because angle has been increased. After a particular angle, then the strain is built. Mean in case of cycloheptane, again strain is built. Means angle increases at some level, up to some extent, at some level, as it is reached at 120 degree, then after 120 degree again strain is built. That is why we say that cyclohexane is stainless. There is no strain in cyclohexane, there is no angle strain in cyclohexane. A good method of determining the stability of a alicyclic compound is to calculate the heat of combustion per methyl group. According to the following table, the heat of combustion value decreases and stability increases from cyclopropane to cyclohexane. The heat of combustion value for cyclohexane is 157.4 kilo per mole, which is equal to that of normal hydrocarbon, indicating that cyclohexane is completely stainless. Heat of combustion of cycloalkanes per methyl group, this is the cyclopropane and this is heat of combustion, and this is cyclobutane, cyclopentane, cyclohexane, cycloheptane, cyclooctane, cyclononane, cyclodecane, cyclounodecane, cyclodidecane, cyclotriticane, cyclotetradecane. Similarly, as the number of n values of carbon increases in infinity, it has, you can see that only in at 157 heat of combustion, 157, which is equal to that normal hydrocarbon, indicating that the cyclohexane is completely stainless. The heat of combustion value then rises again slightly in medium sized ring due to some eclipsing of bond and finally it drops to normal value of 157.4 kilojoule per mole in 14 member ring. These and larger rings are completely stainless. For quantitative evaluation, the carbon-carbon valency angle is saturated hydrocarbons. In saturated hydrocarbon is 112 degree is taken as a standard. The angle of deformation can be correlated with the angle of strain V naught by the equation V naught equal to half of the K theta into change in theta square. K theta is the bond bending force constant. It has similar values for carbon-carbon bond angles. The above equation may be deduced to V theta is equal to 0.01 into del theta square K kilocalorie per mole per degree cube. This is the equation through which we can correlate the angle strain by using the equation, and there are different methods for to check the stability of cycloalkanes, alicyclic compounds from heat of combustion of paraC2 group can be also understand, and from this formula we can also see the strain in the cyclohexane in cycloalkane structures. Then fused ring system, decalene, cis and transform decalenes are possible. This is cis, 3 staggered, 15 CQ interactions, and this is trans, 6 staggered and 12 CQ arrangements. These are the cis trans decalene. Hence it is clearly shown that the trans form is more stable as compared to cis form, due to because it has 6 staggered conformation, it has 3 staggered conformation. The cis form has 10 kilojoule per mole energy, less stable than the trans form. The cis form has 10 kilojoule per mole energy, less stable than the trans form. That is it. I have asked you that trans form more stable. 2 conformation of cis decline are possible, which rapidly convert into each other so that an equilibrium is obtained. These are the 2 forms. Cis decline shows 1 peak in proton NMR. Trans decline shows 2 peaks of axial and torsional protons. Means from the proton mass spectroscopy, you can differentiate between the 2 isomers. The cis decline shows 1 peak in proton NMR because all the protons are in one environment, while in case of trans decline shows 2 peaks of axial and torsional protons. In case of cis, the proton NMR spectroscopy cannot differentiate between the axial and torsional orientation, while in case of trans, the 2 peaks of axial and torsional protons can be easily understandable, and the trans decline shows 2 peaks of axial and torsional protons. Means the axial and torsional protons in case of trans have 2 peaks. Then there is parhydrophenanthrene. Parhydrophenanthrene, there are 6 conformations possible. You can see this is ectorial, then ectorial. This is trans, anti, trans. Again, this is axial, ectorial, then ectorial, then ectorial. This is plus minus cis anti trans. Again, this is ectorial, this is axial, again this is axial and this is ectorial, then plus minus cis sin trans, and again this is axial and this is ectorial, this plus minus cis anti cis, because 2 similar bonds are moving away from each other, that's why these are called cis anti cis. And this is cis sin cis meso. This is axial, this is ectorial, this is ectorial, this is axial, again axial and then ectorial. When you see that there's a plane of symmetry in the compounds, that's why this is cis sin cis meso. This is the meso, and again this is bictorial, ectorial, and this is bi axial. This is trans sin trans. Again, this is a meso, then there is a plane of symmetry. If the compounds contain a plane of symmetry, the compounds become optically inactive. These both conformation are optically inactive, while other four conformations are optically active. This is the perhydrophenanthrene. It shown the different conformations are possible, and this is again the pseudo rotations of carbon around the ring. Then there's pyrenes. If two rings are I have discussed a lot about the pyrenes, if two rings are fused to each other so that only one atom is common to both, then the compound is pyrene. This pyro 2-2 pentane, this is 1 chlorospyro 5-3 nonane. The numbering begins with the smaller ring and ends on the junction of the carbon atoms. The two rings are perpendicular to each other, therefore suitably substituted pyrenes will have to no element of symmetry. They will be optically active. Examples are the dilactones of benzophenone 2-2-4-4 tetracarboxylic acid. These are pyrenes. This is the pyrene spirohydrination, and this is also spiro compounds. Various spiro compounds have been prepared in which the spiro atoms in ring phosphorus are arsenic. This is plus minus 4 carboxy 4 phenyl bispiridinium 11 spirene bromide. Alenes, in alenes one carbon atom is joined to other carbon atom with double bonds. The plane containing A and B is at right angle to that containing D and E. The compound is optically active because it is asymmetric as a whole, although it does not contain asymmetric carbon atom. Chirality due to heteroatoms. Nitrogen, we have already seen that tertiary amines a formula and it cannot be resolved. However, quaternary ammonium salt of the type NMHD are resolvable. They are tetrahedral structure, and therefore there are two forms NMHD which are not superimposable on each other. The first compound of this type to be resolved was allyl benzyl methyl phenyl ammonium iodide, which was resolved with the help of bromo camphor sulfonic acid. Then phosphorus, just like tertiary amines, phosphines of general formula PABC are pyramidal and cannot be resolved because of acylation of phosphorus atom at right angle to the plane containing ABC. However, the frequency of acylation 6 × 10³ per second is much slower here than in the tertiary amines 2.3 × 10, and if it can be brought to zero, then phosphines of this type can be resolved. This can be achieved by increasing the size of the A, B and C. Thus, Horner in 1961 resolved phosphorus ethyl methyl phenyl, phosphorus methyl phenyl propyl, etc. Quinovalent phosphorus compounds. Let us take the example of phosphine oxides. Compounds of the type PABCO have been resolved. Sulfur and selenium can also take the place of oxygen. Optically active phosphine oxides are racemized by acid. This is due to the formation of symmetrical compound having trigonal pyramidal configurations. This is the phosphorus containing compounds which can be resolved easily, which is resolvable. Then there is sulfur containing compounds, sulfonium salt. This is the reaction. Here dimethyl sulfide react with alpha bromo acetic acid. That results in formation of this salt. This is chloroplatinate salt, has surface rotation of plus 4.5 degree in water. Similarly, the picrate of compound was obtained in two enantiomeric form, one with alpha d 8.1 degree and other minus 9.2 degree. Sulfoxide of the type have been resolved. This is the sulfoxide, and they have pyramidal structures. This was a whole about the conformation and of unhetero due to heteroatoms, and we have discussed anomeric effect, and the anomeric effect and heteroatoms play an important role in stereochemistry. If you have any problem, you can discuss with me, you can ask me question. This is very easy topic and easily understandable, if you have any question, you can ask and you can put your question in the Google Classroom and I will try to give you answer. Thank you. Allah Hafiz. Good luck.